Hi, my dear children of class 9th. This video is a part 2 of Unit 3 Digital Documentation. Let's move on to the glimpse. Creating a document, parts of writer, cursor movement, editing the document, selecting non-consecutive text, selecting a vertical block of text, find and replace, jumping to the page number, checking spelling and grammar, using synonyms and thesaurus, difference between dictionary and thesaurus. So these are the topics which we have covered in this video. Let's take these topics one by one. Creating a document. There are two steps. First one is, you need to click on the file menu, then you will click on new. You will find the option text document. Now, once you have opened or created a document, you can save it by clicking on the file menu again and clicking on the save. Then you have to write the name for that particular document. How you will be able to close the document? Click on file, there will be an option to close, then the document will be closed. How you will be able to reopen that particular document? You have to click on file, then you will click on open. Now you need to navigate to the place, like the file explorer will come in front of you, and you need to navigate to the place where you have saved that particular document, right? To save the document with password, sometimes you people are getting few documents where some passwords are set. So how you will be able to do that? There, while saving the document, there is a tick mark, a checkbox where there is a like save with a password option. Once you will tick that up, then you will get an option to write the password. Once you will write the password, there is a field in which you need to rewrite that particular password. Then you will click on OK. Let's move on to the next slide now. Parts of the writer. There are 8 parts of the particular writer. One is title bar, menu bar, toolbar, then there is a standard toolbar and a formatting toolbar, status bar, scroll button and a scroll bar, and zoom. I think you have many times gone through these particular menus, so I need not to explain it here, but if you will say, I'll explain it tomorrow in the new class. Cursor movement. Text cursor movement. Observe the location of the text cursor. Press the different cursor control keys on the keyboard and watch how text cursor move around. Now, if we'll talk about the text cursor, it's a flashing line. Whenever you are typing something, it's a flashing line onto your particular screen. And you can move that. There are 4 arrows in your keyboard. You can move the cursor from one place to another, up and down, left and right. There are 2 keys above cursor control keys. These are the cursor control keys. There are 2 keys above it. What are those? One is home and another is end. Once you will click the home key, adding to control key, that means you have to hold control key, then you have to press on the home, then your cursor will move to the very very beginning of your particular document, right? Once you will hold the control key, you will press on the end key, the cursor will move onto the last line of your document. Now there are mouse pointer also. You can point your mouse at any place, and where you will click, that flashing line will blink over there. It takes the pointer shape while moving it around the screen. The mouse pointer changes to flashing line, that is eye shape, when the cursor is moved onto the document, right? So whenever you are onto the screen, the document is not there, you will get an arrow. But if you have the Word document in front of you, then you will have 2 types of cursor. One is a flashing line. You can move that by using the control keys, right? Arrow. And another is the arrow key, where once you will move your mouse, like see, if I'll move it like this, you people can see this arrow. This kind of arrow is also there, which is the mouse pointer, right? Okay, let's move on. Editing the document, undo and redo. I think most of you will be like having an idea what is undo and what is redo. Once you want to erase something, you will do undo. Once you want to like by mistake, if you have erased something which was the important part, you can do redo and you will get that particular thing, right? Moving and copying. Moving is, see, just for an example, if you have like asked for the notebook to your friend, you were absent one day and you have taken the notebook to copy the work. Now what you will do? You will copy that particular work into your own notebook. One is this. That means you will copy and paste. That means the original copy will be as it is and you have copied the content. That is copy and paste. Now what is cut and paste? If you tear down the pages from that particular original copy and paste it onto your own notebook, then what will happen? The original place, like the pages from the original place, will be missing and it will be pasted in your own notebook. That means cut and paste. The original copy will not be having that particular text, right? Selecting text is necessary to perform copy and paste operation. The selected text will be highlighted. Now, why I have kept this thing into bold? While performing the operations, moving and copying, you people forgot to select the text. So the very first step is to select the text, and then that text will be highlighted. It seems like highlighted, and then you can copy and paste. Now see, there are a few shortcuts. To cut a text, you will use CTRL, that control key with X, right? Now to paste it, V with control key. Paste is V. To copy it, C with control key, right? So let's move on. Editing document continues. Now there are some selection criteria. To select the text in Writer, swipe the mouse cursor over the text, and there are several selection tricks to speed up the selection process as below. Now see, if you want to select a single word, what you will do? You will double click. If you want to select a complete sentence, what you will do? You will triple click. And if you want to select a complete paragraph at a time, you will click 4 times onto the mouse. A document, if you want to select the whole document, then you have to press A with control key. Control plus, right? Let's move on. And revise this. This particular table will be coming into your examination. Important. Selecting non-consecutive text. If the text is not non-consecutive, if you are having a text like you want to select first line, then the fourth line, then the fifth line, then the eighth line and the 12th line, what you will do? Select the first piece, hold down the control key, select the next piece and repeat this as often as needed. This is from mouse. Now if you want to select the things from keyboard, select the first text, press shift plus F8. Adding selection mode will be on for like after pressing shift plus F8. Now you can use the arrow keys to select the next pieces, right? And you can repeat as often as required. Moving on to the next, selecting a vertical block. If you want to select a vertical block, what you will do? It is possible that you can select a vertical block or a column of a text that is separated by spaces or tab. And how you will do? You will use your mouse. You will drag the mouse onto the first place to the last place, and the whole column will be selected, right? Find and replace. Sometimes we are having, say for example, I'm having a book of 1,000 pages and I want to find a particular word or a topic. So one thing is, I navigate to whole 1,000 pages and find where is that text. Another is find and replace option, where you will get, select the edit option, where you will, there will find and replace. A dialog box will appear, then you can write the text, and once you will click on OK or find, then you will get. This is one way. Another is CTRL plus F. F after CTRL. CTRL ko hold karna hai, then you will press on F. Then also that particular dialog box will appear and you will be able to write the content which you want to find. Now jumping to page number, there is a go to page feature of Writer which is very useful, where you will get edit menu, go to page. If you want to know the shortcut, shortcut is CTRL plus D. Write the page number and you will be navigated. Next is checking spelling and grammar. If you want to check the spelling and grammar, then what do you need to do? You need to go to the tools where you will find spelling and grammar. Now, you need to, like one dialog box will appear in front of you. You can select automatic spell checker and then it will recognize the words where you are doing the mistake, right? And if you don't want to follow that particular step, tools and then spelling and grammar, what you can do, you can press F7 and you will get that, right? Moving on to the next now, using synonyms and thesaurus. This is very, very nice thing. Once you have typed some word or the paragraph and you want to make some kind of change, you want to add some synonyms, you have to just right click on that particular word and the words which are inside the dictionary, which are the synonyms of this particular word, will be in that particular, like if you will right click, there is a small pop-up window will in front of you, and then you can click on the any synonyms which you find suitable for your particular document. This is the synonyms. Okay, now what is thesaurus? Thesaurus is a place where we can find the similar meaning or the opposite meaning, right? So from the thesaurus, the synonyms and antonyms are coming, right? Now the difference between dictionary and thesaurus, dictionary tells the meaning basically, right, and the pronunciations, but thesaurus tells the similar meaning or the opposite, that is synonyms and antonyms. This is the difference and this can come in the examination, very important. Next, now my dear children, thank you for your attention and I'll see you soon in the online class. Bye bye, take care.